Meet Justice Sharad Arvind Bopde, the Chief Justice of India Designate, who comes from a family of lawyers from Nagpur, and he takes oath on the 18th of November. Sir, you come from a family of advocates and you have a wide experience. So how do you see your priorities, particularly in the Supreme Court?
The priorities are straightforward. The goal of any judicial system is justice. And that is one thing that cannot be sacrificed. All other priorities are after this. And there are certain aspects which need attention, like case flow management. Then the staffing of courts, then that includes vacancies, then use of technological means like artificial intelligence.
Excellent, sir.
Then there is a very important long-term priority, and that is legal education. Because one believes that the only lasting solution or the only sure cause of excellence for producing good lawyers and good judges is sound legal education. It's a long-term measure, which I think therefore it often gets neglected because you never see the results during your...
Correct. You said artificial intelligence. How can it be used in Supreme Court, sir? Because I heard that you're a tech-savvy.
There are many uses of artificial intelligence. one is creating a legal research assistant. I mean, the artificial intelligence answers questions pertaining to the particular case. Then it takes away the drudgery of repetitive tasks and leaves the judge free to decide, to apply his mind to the growth of the law and development of the law. And clubbing of cases, bunching together of cases and things like that.
Is it already in the works, sir?
No, we have a committee. We have a committee, and that committee also has some experts who are in the process of seeing what kind of artificial intelligence to use in which part of the court proceedings or which procedure.
Sir, now actually, after a long, long time, there are 34 judges in the Supreme Court. Do you think it will help you to, reduce the pendency of cases?
Of course, of course. In fact, one of the interesting things is there are so many matters which require a decision by five judges, which the Chief Justice could not spare five judges to sit and decide those matters because the other work would get affected.
Correct.
Now you can.
Sir, so coming to the other issue of the collegium, people, of course, collegium in Deepak Mishra's period, all the resolutions are put on the website. Now people say still more transparency is needed. What's your view, sir?
I think there is sufficient transparency. Most of the time when some people demand greater transparency, they want to know the causes why somebody was not selected.
Exactly, sir. That's my next question.
Yeah. Why somebody was not selected. They are not interested so much in why somebody was selected. They are interested in why somebody was not selected. And that normally involves very negative things about a candidate. Okay. And I don't see why a candidate should subject himself to this kind of negative exposure only because he is considered for judgeship or considered for elevation to the Supreme Court.
Achha, that's the reason the reasons are not, put on the website. Yes. Or
as I was telling somebody earlier in the evening, it's not a question of secrecy, it's a question of privacy.
I see. I think you are part of that privacy judgment also. Yes. Sir, even some judges who recuse from hearing some cases, some judges give reasons, others don't give. It gives some sort of doubts in the minds of the litigants.
I do not believe that a judge should disclose reasons for recusing. You see, recusal is a matter of a judge's conscience. He feels that he cannot be impartial, he cannot do justice without any pangs. That is why he recuses. It's a matter of conscience. And many times, a judge is not sure whether he should hear it. Many times, the judge is not sure what makes him recuse. Why should a judge give reasons? And that has never been the tradition. As I understand, throughout the history of the judiciary, a judge has never been asked to disclose why he is not hearing a case.
Sir, how do you see the relationship between the judiciary and the government?
It's a relationship which thrives on mutual respect.
Each has to respect the each other. One has to.
Yes, I mean the government has a lot of power in the sense that the courts do not have any financial power. The courts do not have any power to
infrastructure,
things like that. It has no. They don't have. They can't give grants to themselves. The system requires the government to do that. Then the staff, then all orders are made in the name of the executive. Exactly. Like the President of India appoints judges of the Supreme Court and the High Court. So the Constitution requires the two wings to function
together.
For the country.
Sir, of late it has been seen that whatever the recommendations of collegium being sent, it's getting delayed by the government. How to speed it up? Do you have any sort of...
No, I don't think it is getting delayed. In fact, collegium recommendations are being processed much faster than I remember. Okay. There are some which have happened because of some... we made some last minute changes, then you have to go through the process of asking for consent. Normally, they don't delay. Okay. Normally, there's no delay.
So, one or two cases which recently I don't want
happen.
To...
It can happen anywhere.
Secondly, sir, this is one of the recent issues about yesterday, this United Nations panel has said that the Supreme Court is slow in dealing with the habeas corpus and media restrictions cases, particularly in J&K case concern.
I would not comment on that.
Sir, which case do you think is a milestone in your judicial history? Probably Ayodhya, 40 days you sat together, may it be one of the...
Yeah. No, Ayodhya is definitely important. It is one of the most important cases in the world today.
And sir, talking about the collegium things, even do you think the transfers, no need to give any reasons, some judges are being transferred?
There's always a paradox here. When the collegium transfers a judge from one place to another, that judge must go there with a good reputation for him to be effective. Why should the collegium say negative things about a judge while transferring? And many times there are not any negative things.
But recent one case which created much of the thing...
It is not the first time it happened. It has happened in the past also. But it's unfortunate. One thing I want to make very clear. There may be larger and smaller high courts because there are larger and smaller states.
So that being said, sent to a smaller high court.
No, there may be larger and smaller high courts because there are larger and smaller states, but there are no bigger and smaller chief justices. Chief justices are equal. Equal in status, equal in powers, equal in remuneration, everything.
One feels so it's a smaller, it's one perception.
No, but there are smaller states. That's different from a chief justice.
Sir, the death penalty, there is a lot of debate going on. What's your personal view on the death penalty?
Judges take the oath to uphold the law. The law provides for a death penalty today. If the court thinks it is, and its constitutional validity has been upheld.
So as long as it's in the statute book, it has to be.
We take the oath to uphold the law. It is on the statute book.
Sir, Justice Ranjan Gogoi is just so neighbor. You are in 7, Krishna Menon Mahogi is in 5. So you worked very closely, even in the Ayodhya bench also. How do you term your relationship with Justice Gogoi?
Excellent relationship. Excellent working relationship. I mean, he's from Assam, I'm from Nagpur. We don't know each other in the sense before we came here. But we developed a good relationship of late.
What's your advice to the young lawyers? Particularly young lawyers look to the Chief Justice, they come to court number 1 to argue their cases. What's your message to them?
Be fearless. Be learned. Not reckless.
Thank you, sir. That was Justice Sharad Arvind Bopde, would be delivering the Ayodhya judgment. After that, you would be taking oath on 18. Thank you very much, sir. All the best.
Thank you.